An annular eclipse is a type of solar eclipse that occurs when the moon passes between the Earth and the Sun, but does not completely cover the Sun's disk. During this type of eclipse, the moon appears slightly smaller in the sky when compared to the Sun, and this creates a ring-like appearance on the Sun's outer edge. This type of eclipse is sometimes referred to as the Ring of Fire. An annular eclipse happens because the moon's orbit around the Earth is elliptical, and that means the distance between the Earth and moon varies. When the moon is at its farthest point from the Earth, called apogee, it appears smaller in the sky. So if a solar eclipse occurs when the moon is at or near apogee, it doesn't fully block out the sun, and you get that ring effect around the sun. Welcome to Learn the Sky. My name is Janine, and I'll be your guide as we explore the night sky one constellation at a time. Let's review what you need to know about the solar eclipse. The solar eclipse is when the moon covers the sun, and they're always seen during the daytime. The moon's narrow shadow casts a pathway on the Earth, and in order to see the solar eclipse, you need to be along the path of totality. So for the solar eclipse that's coming up on October 14th of 2023, here is that pathway of totality. Here in North America, we're lucky because we have two different types of solar eclipses coming up that are within 1 year span. I would say anyone who's living in Texas is pretty lucky because you're going to be right in the spot you need to be to see both types of solar eclipses. And remember, with the ring eclipse, this is the effect that you are going to see. The moon is farther away in its orbit, so it doesn't completely cover the sun, and you get this really cool ring effect. Is a very cool animation that shows what it looks like when the moon's shadow passes across the Earth. And here's another one for you. You can see as the Earth is spinning, this is the moon's shadow. And I've got one more cool picture for you. This is a picture of a solar eclipse viewed from the International Space Station. And the three types of eclipse that do exist are the total solar eclipse, and this is where the moon completely covers the sun's disks. Here is a partial eclipse where it only covers a part of the sun. And the one coming up on October 14th in 2023 is an annular eclipse or a ring eclipse. And no matter which type of solar eclipse you are viewing, it's really important that you have eye protection. It's dangerous to look at the sun directly and that can cause permanent eye damage. There are so many reasons why solar eclipses are special events. First, they are rare. So the few times that they do happen, you have to be in a very specific location to see them. They also can cause a dramatic visual display. When the moon completely covers the sun, it darkens the daytime sky, and we get to see very special features of the sun, such as the corona. The corona is the outermost layer of the sun's atmosphere, and it's usually hidden. So during a solar eclipse, we are able to do scientific research and study what is going on in the sun's corona. Let's not forget the historical significance that solar eclipses has held throughout the millennia. Many ancient civilizations interpreted eclipses as omens or signs from the gods, and they have been recorded throughout many historical texts and definitely have played a role in shaping cultural narratives. As a teacher, I get really excited about the educational opportunities that solar eclipses offer. We can use this special celestial event to get students engaged in astronomy and going outside and viewing the natural world. I also think solar eclipses are a great excuse to get out there, have an adventure, and travel. To me, travel is always the best teacher. So let me know in the comments below, are you planning to go see the ring eclipse that's coming up in October 14th of 2023? Or are you going to try and see the April 8th one that's happening in 2024? That one is a total solar eclipse. No matter where you are on the planet, I wish you clear skies so you're able to see all the beautiful things that the sky has to offer. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, keep looking up.